I just thought it was a tremendous fight, and it was great to see Tommy Hearns in the audience and later in the ring, because that fight between Crawford and Porter is reminiscent of some of the great welterweight fights that we had in the 80s.
How did you see before, as the rounds were progressing, a lot of people had it very close?
It was very close. I thought that I had Crawford ahead by 2 or 3 points. Some people had 1 point. But again, once there were two knockdowns, that's a 3 point round at least. And there was going to be another knockdown. He was unsteady on his feet.
What type of statement has tonight sent out from Terence to the rest of the division to stop Shawn Porter, who has not been stopped previously?
Well, I don't know if, you know, Terence is a great fighter. He showed he was a great fighter. And he and Spence would be a terrific fight. And so would he and the Scotsman, Josh Taylor.
Josh Taylor's actually stood behind you. From what you saw tonight, how great of a fight would it be between Terence and Josh?
That would be a great, great fight, particularly if we did it for 70,000 people this spring in the UK.
Oh, that can happen, Bob. And final thing, the stoppage itself, was it the right move?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, whether it was the father that stopped it or the referee, he was very valiant, Porter, but he was wobbly, you know, and it would just, he would have been destroyed. And you don't want a kid like that to suffer a permanent injury.
Bob, thank you.
Bob, were you encouraged to see Errol Spence in the building? What does that mean? Does that give some
that
life
for all that PBC gave him a ticket? That's what it means.
Bob, I think it means more than that. Don't you?
Do you think it'll discourage him based on what Terence just did to Shawn Porter?
How the fuck would I know if it would discourage him or encourage him? I mean, you got to ask him. I mean, left. Okay. But again, Errol Spence is a good fighter. He's a brave guy. And whether he wants to fight Terence or not, that's up to him and Al. I'll certainly talk to Al about a possible putting them together.
It's really, I mean, can you make the case? I think a lot of us can. That's the best fight that the welterweight division can make.
Well, no, I think so. The fight I want to see, I would like to see is Terence and Josh Taylor, two of the fighters, one currently and one previously, who were undisputed in their weight class.
For so long, you know, we've talked about it at length. You've struggled with, you know, what Terence can bring in regards to butts to the seats, eyes to the TV. You know, he delivered tonight, didn't he? I mean,
It would seem to me that there was nobody left in Omaha this weekend. That Omaha came here.
Bob, do you believe that fight that Porter and Crawford and Taylor is as lucrative as Spence Crawford?
I think it's more because of the UK. And since that Taylor is huge in the UK, so is Crawford. We can do 70,000 seats and do probably 1.5 million, 2 million pay-per-view, and put it at an hour where we could still do pay-per-view over here in the United States. So I haven't penciled it out completely, but I think the most lucrative fight for Terence would be Josh Taylor.
Well, I know they just got out of the ring, but can you speak to, you know, how you move forward with Terence here with his contract expiring?
That doesn't... Look, Tommy Hearns was in the ring. I never had a contract with Hearns more than one fight. Never had a contract with Leonard more than one fight. Hagler, maybe two fights. But never a long-term contract. We never had a long-term contract. If somebody comes and offers Terence a deal for a lot more money, he'd be a fool not to take it. But we think we can produce the best fight for him. It's got nothing to do with personalities or anything. We know when we put a fight on, the fighters get treated well, they're taken care of. but other people can do that also. So again, Terence will, if he's smart, which I believe he is, will look at all the offers and see what's the best way to go.
You mentioned that, you mentioned if he went to the PBC?
I think it would be stupid for the PBC.
Why?
Look, you have to understand the economics of the business. The pay-per-view business being done by the cable systems and the satellite providers is in the toilet.
Right.
The business, the big business, as proven by the UFC, by Tonight, by the Tyson Fury fight, is being done by ESPN Plus. And we have a contract with ESPN that nobody can put a fight on ESPN Plus except Top Rank. So now if they want to go and do a fight without Top Rank and without ESPN, that's up to them. But I think it would be really foolish for them to do it, for everybody.
With Canelo, they were still able to get to 800,000 pay-per-view.
They said they didn't go close to that. Troy. And also, there's a lot of other elements in what the expenses are and so forth.
Bob, I know you said that Josh Taylor would be the most lucrative fight for Terence Crawford, but do you believe it'll be more difficult than Errol Spence?
Difficult fight?
Yeah.
You know, I think you got to ask Bomac that.
Yeah, I mean, look, you've talked to, go back to the ESPN thing. You've said this before. Didn't the ESPN thing sort of dictate that this fight ended up on ESPN, right? I mean, because you
100%.
Yeah.
100%. Oh, and also put in important, it was such a good event and such a good fight that for the next 4 days, anybody wanting to see it can buy it on ESPN Plus at the same price as it was tonight. See, that gives us the flexibility of picking up a lot of additional buys.
Where's just talking counter punching, where's Crawford ranked that you've seen? Is he one of the best counter punchers you've seen, Bob?
Yeah, he's one of the best fighters around today, you know, but then Tommy gets in the ring and I'll be talking to Ray tomorrow. I mean, they was a pretty good counter punches and pretty good welterweights.
Well, in your head, how did you have the fight going into the tournament?
I had a close, but I had Terence ahead by a couple of points. But again, once there's two knockdowns, that really makes it impossible for Porter to win.
He's the one who said, like, I'm going to talk after the fight is over. Has there been any conversations about the future of this relationship between Crawford and Top Rank?
No.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, Jonathan.